Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 26, where we are going to literally just look at the deep posterior compartment of the leg. We're not actually going to have you identify any of the specifics here. I just wanted you to at least get a look at what it looks like here. So in this particular image, we're looking at a posterior image because I can see the calcaneus here. I can see the sole of the foot. And I can see that the calcaneal tendon has been cut. So that means that that superficial compartment has been completely removed, including the gastrocnemius and the soleus. And you can see that we have these fairly flat, very close to the bone muscles that are making up this deep posterior compartment. And so these are those flexors. You have the flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, the tibialis posterior, in this region, but they're very hard to distinguish from one another. And not that they're not important in terms of playing some role in terms of the flexion or in terms of the inversion of the foot. It's just that they're difficult to tell apart in a kind of picture format. So we're not going to have you identify them specifically. Now, if you are also looking here, you can see a fairly prominent neurovascular bundle traveling through this area. And there's that tibial nerve that is going to innervate that posterior compartment. Remember, tibial nerve equals posterior. So we actually get a little glimpse of it right here in this image. All right, excellent. So we are on to our very last station in station 27. So meet me there and thank you for your time.